So with the recent NVIDIA RTX launch news of the new 3070, 3080, and 3090, NVIDIA might have just completely destroyed next-gen consoles before they even had a chance. And it was clearly intentional. Let me tell you why. And the geniuses among you might notice that I'm actually in my kitchen today. But the reason for that is because now that you can get an RTX 3070 that allegedly beats the 2080 Ti for $499, my 1080 Ti and this guy right here is completely worthless now. And so I just didn't want to have to clean up the mess in my office after doing this. And I must warn you, some of you might find this shocking. So if you get queasy easily, you might want to turn away now because I'm just not going to be needing this guy anymore. Yeah, I think that'll work. Yo guys, Jake Bacon here, and welcome to Bacon Bits Episode 1, where we cook up thoughts on the newest tech news and releases. And a lot of you guys have actually been asking me to cover this, and man, is this an exciting launch. We haven't seen this big of a price drop for the same or better performance on a GPU in a long time. We've got a 3070 with performance as good or better as a 2080 Ti for only $499. I mean, granted if NVIDIA's performance charts are accurate. Now, let me start off with that these are my opinions on the subject, and we still have yet to see any reviews or benchmarks from anyone but NVIDIA, and I know some of you might disagree with me, and I'm completely open to that, and I would love to have a conversation with you guys, a constructive conversation with you in the comments below. This also isn't a technical breakdown, there are plenty of videos on that already, and I will be getting more into that once the cards drop and are in our hands and we can actually do some testing. I'm also going to be explaining, against popular opinion, why I don't think that you guys should be selling your tooth, and I really do think that this launch will disrupt the console industry, but I don't really think that you shouldn't go get one of the new consoles. Consoles are a different market, and this doesn't really matter at all to some people, and the price of the 3070 is still most likely the same as a whole console. But I think what's more important is what that shows for the price of the 3060 and the 3050, etc. will be, and how you're actually going to be able to build an excellent PC gaming machine for around $650 to $800, and that's going to bring a lot of new people into the PC gaming space. Which is why NVIDIA clearly launched these cards before the new consoles. It obviously won't matter to everyone, but I think this will at the very least have a lot of new people considering building a PC over getting one of the new consoles than ever have in the recent years. I mean, the PS5's biggest selling feature has been its SSD tech and super fast loading times. Well, NVIDIA is now implementing this as well. And I knew it was gonna happen eventually, but I never thought that it would be happening this fast and potentially first before the consoles come out. I'm also gonna be having a lot more content around these cards as well as the PS5 and the Xbox Series X. So if you don't wanna miss anything, make sure to hit that subscribe button, massage the like button until it starts to sizzle, and ring the bell for that sweet, sweet smell of bacon in your inbox. Now, should you buy the Founders Edition card? Or should you wait? Because this is a question I've been wondering about as well. Look, I don't think most people realize that this time around, the Founders Edition cards are still custom designs. These aren't reference cards. There is a reference design layout PCB, and an AIB can use this, and it's basically the minimum spec they must follow, but they can customize it with better parts, etc. However, this time around, NVIDIA has not followed this reference design with their FE cards, and they've actually customized this PCB, so neither are the AIBs. This time, I don't think it makes that much sense to wait for an AIB over the FE cards if they are more expensive. And especially not if you plan on water cooling and are not going to take advantage of any of the extra cooling performance. But even then, I think we're gonna be pleasantly surprised with the out-of-the-box cooling performance of the FE cards. Now, we can talk about specs and all the cool features that NVIDIA has announced, like NVIDIA Broadcast, which does look pretty cool, and if the background replacement AI works as well as RTX Voice, then it'll be great. And it looks like the RTX Voice is actually getting lumped in to NVIDIA Broadcast as a suite of AI products. Also, of course, they say it only runs on the RTX GPU. However, if you watch my video here, I was actually able to get RTX Voice to work on a GTX 1080 Ti. So we'll have to be able to see if maybe older cards will actually be able to get some of these new features. And these cards are also boasting good 8K performance, but really, I mean, who's really going to be using 8K at this point? I mean, it's future-proof, I guess, but something super cool to consider is VR performance. If we can get good 8K performance, then we can potentially have 4K in each eye, and I think that that will significantly help the VR experience as a whole, and that's what I'm more excited about for the 8K performance than actual 8K displays. And tech specs are cool, I love them as much as the next guy, but what I really want to talk about is should you go with a 3070, a 3080, or a 3090, or none of them? And should you even wait for independent reviews? And does price of performance matter? And should you be selling your 2000 series graphics cards? Because I know you've probably heard this from a lot of different people, but I think my thoughts are going to be very different than a lot of what you have already heard. And again, these are just my opinions. So TLDR here, if you are in the market for a new GPU and you need or just want the extra performance, then I say no. Do not wait for independent reviews, because I guarantee that these cards will sell out in minutes on launch day. And if you're sitting around waiting on reviews, you're either gonna have to be stuck paying the crazy inflated prices from resellers, which I never think anyone should ever do, or waiting a month at minimum to possibly months on end for these to come back in stock. And also, why would you need to wait? If the numbers are even close to what Nvidia has said, which I'm sure Nvidia has inflated some numbers, but I don't think it's gonna be that much of a difference to make people not want to buy these cards, then you should just go for the best card that you can afford and be done with it. Because worst comes to worst, if performance is not what you expected or promised by Nvidia, you can just return the card. And then I know that there are those of you who are waiting to see what AMD brings to the table, and I'm not bashing AMD here, because I actually am personally running a Ryzen CPU right now, and I love what they did for the CPU industry. But you need to remember again that the 3070, the 3080, and the 3090 are all technically upper tier price cards. And if history tells us anything, AMD has not been able to compete with Nvidia's offerings in this GPU tier very well at all. So yeah, you can wait, but I think it's a huge gamble and you might just be left without a card at that point for a few months if you're wanting a higher end GPU. Now don't get me wrong, if you don't need the card now and you are fine waiting if they sell out and you just don't care, then of course, wait for all the reviews and see what AMD has to offer and then make a decision, because the more data that you can get before making a purchasing decision is never a bad thing. But again, you have to be willing to wait and you need to accept that you really just don't know how long you're gonna have to wait. And none of us really know at this point. Now, that brings me to, what about price of performance? This is probably the most talked about metric there is when it comes to new GPUs and launches and arguments on the internet, and I just think it is way overused and people base way too much or all of their buying decision on it, and I don't think that this is the only way that you should be looking at these launches, and let me tell you why. Oh, and I know that some of you are not gonna agree with what I'm about to say, but just hear me out, and again, I'd love to talk about it with you guys in the comments. And again, TLDR for this is just buy the best card you can afford and be done with it. Stop worrying about all this and instead spend your time playing more games or making more content. And even though price performance for these new cards is so much better than the 2000 series, this still just doesn't seem to be enough for people. I mean, let's talk the 3090. On the surface, the price performance is not great compared to the other options, but you need to realize that this card is not made for 99.99% of you guys. You don't need it. This is really just a Titan rebranded as a gaming card, and I think this was a mistake by Nvidia and what is tripping a lot of people up. Regardless of what Nvidia's marketing says, you need to think of this card for professionals first and gamers second. Yes, it can game, but so could the Titan and so can pretty much any card. So now if you think of it as professionals first, I think you can feel better about it, because most professionals don't care about price to performance. And if they do, it's definitely not the most important metric they look at. Everything that is marketed towards the professional market is overpriced. It's just how it is, because these companies, they have budgets. They can write off different things than consumers can, and they just don't care. Let's say the 3090 is only a 16% improvement over the 3080 for basically double the price. Yes, price performance is awful compared to 3080, but also, which performance are you basing this off of? Because gaming performance, but what about rendering performance and time saved? Because a 60% performance in that category, especially scaled up, could mean the difference on taking a new client or a project or not, and that could mean a lot more money than the cost difference between a 3080 or a 3090. If you are just going to be using this card for gaming, and this card is not really for you. And if you're complaining about the need to buy a bigger PSU for the 3090, then this card also just isn't meant for you. If you just want a game with the best card available and can afford it, then fine, go for it. But really, most of you don't need to worry about this card unless you're a professional who also sometimes games, and price performance is not the most important metric to you. Also, do you guys not care that the 3090 is actually way cheaper at launch than the Titan was? All right, but then what about the 3080 and the 3070? Because this is where you can start really caring more about price performance, and Nvidia has done a tremendous job here. The 3070 is considerably cheaper than the 2080 Ti was, with performance potentially the same or better. Also, again, I think that since the 3070 is the lowest end card being launched right now, people are forgetting that it still isn't a low end card. It's just on the low end of the high end cards. So a lot of you might actually be even better off waiting for the 3060 or the 3050, because with the looks of it, these are gonna be excellent performers for an excellent price. But even then, if you need the performance of a 3080, then what does it matter what the price performance of a 3070 is? If it's better, I mean, because the raw performance still isn't enough for what you need. You need a 380. So if you can afford it, then get it. Now, if AMD also had a card that gave you the same performance, then yeah, at that point, obviously you should compare the price performance between brands, but between different price performance tiers, I just don't think it makes that much sense, unless you only care about getting the best bang for your buck, which is fine, and I know a lot of you care about that, and that's what you care about, and that's what you should do. I mean, I hope this all makes sense. Okay, so cool, you decided on what is important to you, which card you want or need, and if you're okay with waiting for reviews or not, and if you're potentially okay with waiting for months. So then should you sell your 2080 Ti or 2000 series GPU? Well, it still matters what you said to the above questions, but in my opinion, no. I don't think that you should be selling it yet. If you have to sell your card now and want the new cards, and unless you get the money for your old card, you don't have the money to buy the new cards, then yeah, I guess obviously you have to sell. But I could also argue at that point, maybe you should really just be keeping your 2000 series card or even 1000 series card because they're still excellent cards and I think people are forgetting about that. But if you must have the new cards, which I do understand, then it also depends on when you bought that 2000 series card. Because if you bought it say 2 years ago, then you're in a better position to take a cheaper price right now. But if you just bought the 2080 Ti and you're gonna sell it for probably less than half, I just don't think I can recommend that. And also, here's my theory about how launch day will go and the next month after that, and hear me out. I think that these cards are gonna sell out day one, possibly in minutes. I think this will definitely be true for the 3070, most likely for the 3080, and I mean, I guess possibly for the 3090, but that's a wild card. But then the 3070, let's say it's being resold for upwards of $1,000 plus, which I don't think is unreasonable to speculate considering some of the GPU prices right now or in the past. Well, at that point, I think a 2080 Ti for $700, $800, even maybe up to $1,000 is gonna look pretty nice. So you might not be able to get near what you paid for originally, but you will be able to get a lot more than what I've seen people have been selling them for now. I could be wrong, but only time will tell, I guess. Anyways, a lot of people have been asking me to cover this subject, and I thought it'd be more interesting to give you guys my opinion than just tech specs, and I think my opinion is different than what a lot of people have been saying. So I guess just let me know in the comments what you think, or if you think I'm crazy, I mean, that's fine. And I'd love to just get a constructive convo going. And also let me know what you want me to cover next, and I'm happy to do so. And also please make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter. I love talking with you guys, and I think that's the best way to get a hold of me. All right, if you like this video, go ahead and like it. It really helps me out the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe for more, and always remember, in bacon we trust. Peace.